Hi, I'm Mike Munster with the Plant Disease and Insect Clinic at North Carolina State University. And this video will show how to take a proper sample for diagnosis of problems with vegetables and bedding plants. First, make sure that you choose a sample representative of the problem. Ideally, this will be several plants showing different degrees of symptoms, from mild to severe. Plants that have been long dead are not useful for diagnosis. Before taking the sample, if possible, get some photographs of the situation at several distances and angles, showing the general landscape bed or garden, and then close-ups of the affected plants and parts. If possible, upload those pictures to our database with the sample information. Very often, problems in the above-ground portions of the plant reflect conditions in the roots or soil. So we want, if possible, a sample of an entire plant. If they're very small, take several plants, again showing a range of symptoms. If they're somewhat larger, two or three would be sufficient. In the case of an extremely large plant or vine, you may want to take just a sample of the roots, a generous fistful of the fine feeder roots in about a quart of soil, and some cuttings showing the symptomatic portions of the above ground plant. Always dig. Do not pull the plant from the soil. Wrap the roots and the soil around them in a plastic bag and fasten it loosely about the base of the plant so that the soil doesn't get on the foliage. Then place the entire plant in a second plastic bag. Don't add any moisture to the bag and avoid leaving the sample in the sun after taking it. Following these simple steps will allow you to give us the best possible sample so that we can provide you with the best possible diagnosis. If you have any questions, contact us at the PDIC. And thank you for watching.